So guys, hopefully I can get this right this time. Third take's a charm. Anyways, today I'm going to be doing bushcraft experience. Another bushcraft experience. And that is going to be bushcraft shelters built versus bought. Or brought. Not bought, but brought. Both are bought. So anyways, let's get into this. And before we get into this, please don't forget to comment, like, share. Definitely share this video and subscribe if you're not already. As I mentioned, today we're going to be talking about built versus brought bushcraft shelters, and we're going to be discussing the pros and cons of both a built shelter out in the woods and a brought shelter that you're bringing out into the woods. So if you guys have been around the channel for any time, you guys will know probably already that I'm a big fan of building shelters, and I've really loved it. And for the past 4, 5, 6 years, that's what I've really been doing with bushcraft slash survival, is just building shelters. But here of late, I have really wanted to change it up and change up my style a little bit, get more experience with other types of forms of bushcrafting. So I've been bringing in shelters. So I thought today I would go over my experiences with both bringing and building shelters out in the woods and discuss some of their pros and cons. So like I said, with most of my experience being with built shelters, we're going to start off with built shelters, the pros of built shelters and the cons of built shelters. So the first and probably most important part about a built shelter is the fact of learning how to build a shelter. That is a very important fact. Because unlike water or food, you can go a few days without either of those. But if you're in a very inclement environment, whether it be a hot desert or a snowfall winter environment, you will need a shelter. You will need to seek shelter, and you will likely need a fire as well in the snow. But you will, if nothing else, need a shelter. And so learning how to build a shelter is a very important skill. And so that's one of the first and biggest pros to building shelters, is it teaches you how to do that, because that's the best way to learn how to build a shelter, is through experience of building shelters. This way you'll know how to build shelters faster and more efficiently than if you had not learned how to build shelters. So that's the first and biggest pro to it. The second one, and I'm not sure how to fully title this, but it's essentially the nicety of having your shelter already there and assembled, so that when you come into your shelter area, it's already there. You don't have to set up the shelter, it's already there. So essentially, to give you an example, like with the Wikiup, you can just walk in, throw your backpack and your gear in the Wikiup, you know, pick up the stuff that you don't or you want to use, and leave the rest of the stuff that you may use later, and go on your day. Whereas if you were using a brought shelter, you'd have to go to your area, take all your stuff, put it all down, you know, take your shelter out, and then set up the shelter, and you know, then put your stuff under it. And the same goes for, you know, when you're done for the day or the week, whatever, you have to, or if you have a built shelter, you can just put all your stuff back in the backpack and then, you know, pick up your backpack and leave. Whereas if you have a brought shelter, you have to take down the shelter, put it all in your backpack, and then leave. So it's more complicated, it takes more time for a brought shelter, but with a built shelter, it's very nice to have it already made. So the next plus side to it is lightweight, or the weight of it. If you're bringing a shelter out, you have to factor any of the built stuff. So things like this tarp, you know, they're pretty lightweight, but they still weigh something. And most importantly, they still take up precious backpack space. So if you build a shelter that's already out, weight that you don't have to carry with you, and that's more space in your backpack that you have to use to put other gear in there. And I know this is something that I've personally enjoyed quite a few times, because like I said, having the lighter weight backpack or the ability to put more stuff in your backpack that you want to use is a very nice plus. Another plus, or big plus to it, is creativity. And while it does require more skill, it's very nice to have the overall creativity of being able to build things like rope ladders and aerial shelters. And these are things that you just really can't build with just like tarps. If you just bring stuff in with you, you don't have as much creativity, because you only have that much space, you only have that much capability. And while you still have a lot of creativity with these types of shelters that you bring in, building things is the ultimate creativity, because like I said, you can build things like rope ladders or elevated platform shelters. You can do a lot of very awesome things with the environment around you using the wood and a little bit of cordage that you might bring in with you to build some really awesome. Now let's get into the downsides or some of the large negatives to building a shelter. So one of the two biggest negatives to it is, one, the build quality, and two, the build time. That's probably the worst one. But build quality, and what I mean by this is, because you're using the materials around you for the most part, they're not going to be as airtight, or they're not going to be as reflection and heat. Things that are really nice are things like this mylar, but obviously there's no naturally occurring mylar around you, so you can't necessarily have that heat reflection. And something that I noticed when I began to switch over to bringing shelters in as opposed to building them was, because I was using man-made materials like these nylons and stuff like that, it actually blocked a lot of the wind out, like no wind. In addition, there was no water getting through, there was no wind getting through, so overall it was really nice. And so that was a really big plus to it. In addition, or that's a really big negative as well to the natural materials. In addition, like I said, one of the biggest negatives is the build time. With the WikiUp, once again using it, it took me about 2 months to build that shelter fully and get it absolutely ready for winter. And so that's a really big disadvantage. And while admittedly I wasn't working on it every single day, I worked on it about once a week. And so it took a while to get it fully ready and fully usable. Unlike these shelters that, you know, once you set them up, they're entirely ready and they're very fast and efficient. Like I can set this up in about 10 minutes, whereas it takes me about 2 months to set up a WikiUp. So that is a really big advantage or disadvantage really to the built shelters, and a really strong advantage to brought shelters. So the next part is mobility. This is something that's a definite strong suit to brought shelters, but built shelters, essentially, you set it up in one area, and while you can move them, they're very hard to move. They're very, you know, not easy to move. They weigh a lot generally, and overall, they're just not really designed to be moved. So with a built shelter, overall, they're not really designed to be moved, and that can be kind of sucky, because I know one of the big things was, as I was moving around in the woods and going like deeper into the woods and discovering new areas, I really wanted to set up new shelters in these areas to, you know, like spend the night or whatever. And it was kind of sucky because my shelter area was like back a mile that way, and it was like, you know, it kind of sucked because you can't easily move the WikiUp from here to here. So that is a big disadvantage to built shelters, is they're just not very mobile. Though, however, if you are just going to stay in one area for a long period of time, they will work very well. So the next part, and this is kind of a disadvantage, is scale. And once again, talking about things like building a rope ladder or building, especially something like an elevated platform shelter, they require a lot more skill. And you have to know what you're doing. And if you don't know what you're doing, you can get hurt with them. Especially like I was saying with the elevator platform, you know, that thing is like 7 feet off the ground. So if you don't know what you're doing, they can, you know, it can collapse on you and you can get really hurt. But once again, it does allow you more creativity, but you do need to have the skill, and you have to do a lot more research about, you know, building them, how to build them, and then, you know, take more time. As well, in addition, not only may it require more skill to do more advanced work, it also might require better tools. Once again, something like a cabin might really require a larger saw or a chainsaw to be effectively built. So the last part, and this is one that I probably like the least about built shelters, is their maintenance. And that is that if you have a shelter constantly going, you know, constantly built out in the woods, it will require maintenance. Things happen to it. So some of the things that have happened to my shelters are, I build a lot of the insulation, a lot of just the overall cover out of spruce boughs. And spruce boughs are great for about 6 months to a year, but they generally wear out and you have to replace them. So there's that. Also, another thing is winter, or the snowfall, especially up here in Alaska, can be so great at times. And I'll roll in a picture of one of my first lean-tos where the ridgepole actually got bent in because there was so much snow weight on it that actually bent it in. And another one is, and this is one of the big ones you have to watch, and what I had to watch with my aerial shelter was with, if you use paracord or really any kind of cordage, especially during the winter or right before the winter, like late fall, squirrels love to come along and they love to chew up that cordage, and that can really, really destroy your shelters. And once again, it can make it unsafe for things like aerial shelters to be used if they've been damaged. So you have to keep up with these different types of things, and you have to maintain your shelters, your built shelters over time. So those are some of the biggest cons getting into the pros of brought shelters. So one of the probably biggest and one of my most favorite things about brought shelters is mobility. As I mentioned with a built shelter, when you build it, it's set up there for pretty much ever, or until it, you know, like rots or it goes away, you know, it decomposes. But with a built shelter, or with a brought shelter rather, you can bring it in and move it around. It's designed to be mobile and it's designed to be moved around. And so this is a very nice thing because, like I said, when I'm pushing back into the woods, when I'm doing more exploration, I may not want to set up a shelter here when I still want to go deeper into the woods and explore more about it. However, if it's nighttime, you know, or I have to factor something because, you know, I need some place to shelter me for the night. So having a nice and very mobile shelter system is a very this, and as I've talked about a little bit with the built shelters, with these brought shelters, because they're pretty much always man-made materials like these, you know, you get wind and waterproof, you get things like Mylar that actually reflect your heat back at you, so you can make shelters that are really efficient in the way they work and very, very comfortable to utilize. The next part is versatility, and what I mean by this is generally when you build a wiki up, if you build it correctly, you get a wiki up, and so you can't really change it. And this is most especially with lean-tos. Like when you build a lean-to, you get a lean-to, and hopefully. And one of the problems with this is if the wind or climate change while you're out there trying to utilize your shelter, this can make your shelter a lot less fun and or effective while you're trying to utilize it. Something that I've liked, and you guys have noticed with my built shelter or brought shelters, is that, like, especially on windy days, I'll set this shelter up to be more of a wind barrier, and I have a lot more versatility with this type of shelter because, especially this UGQ one that has like quarter panel attachments and stuff like that, so it's pretty fancy. But for the most part, with any shelter, you can use it and really change the different type of shelter you have, all with this one piece of shelter. Like this one tarp can be many different shelters, and so this allows you that, say you get out to a place and it's not windy or rainy when you get there, so you set up a pretty basic lean-to style tarp, but then it gets windy and rainy, or say you get caught in a thunderstorm, it's really nice to change this tarp into a or tent for you to hide out in for the rain to pass. And so that type of versatility is really awesome, and that's one of the biggest things that I do like about brought shelters. So now into some of the disadvantages of brought shelters. So one of the biggest and one of the most prohibitive disadvantages to the brought shelters is their price. Once again, these types of shelters, like this really awesome tarp, is really awesome, but this thing costs over $100. This Mylar blanket here costs around $20. So these different things can be very cost prohibitive. Whereas once again, if you're working with the woods, I mean, you could factor, you know, your axe being like $150, or, you know, your knife being $150, but those are things that you're gonna use regardless to the shelter building or not. So I don't really like to factor those. So when you're out in the woods, for the most part, you know, if you have any permits, those might factor, but for the most part, the wood is pretty free to use, especially if it's like lying on the ground dead, it's pretty free to use. And so there's no cost to building a shelter other than, of course, the time that it would take. So one of the biggest disadvantages to brought shelters is their price point. Once again, the nicer ones can be very expensive, and that can make it very prohibitive to getting a brought shelter. And I know that's something that's definitely really prohibited me, or not necessarily prohibited me, but not really made me want to get into these types of brought shelters. Is large glaring flaw or disadvantage to brought shelters is, of course, their weight, and more importantly, the size they take up in the backpack. These are things that you do have to account for, and they can be definitely accounted for. I know something like my Camelback linchpin has external carrying areas where you can carry things like this on the bottom of the backpack. So that is a nice thing, but if your backpack doesn't have that, or you don't want to put this on the outside of your backpack, you have to factor that one, it's going to take up space, and regardless to where you put it, it's going to add weight to your backpack. And so these are things that you really have to focus on, because pretty soon you could have a very heavy backpack if you try and incorporate too much shelter building supplies into your backpack. Probably the final thing that I dislike, or the disadvantage to bra shelters, is because oftentimes they are made of these awesome man-made materials, they're often very hard to repair. So with a built shelter, if, let's just say, you know, something cracks or breaks on the shelter, or, you know, whatever happens to it, with maintenance, it's very easy to, or pretty easy most times, to repair a shelter. Whereas if you damage, or let's say, you know, you cut this tarp, or, you know, a piece of hot ember lands on the tarp and burns a small hole in the tarp, it can be a lot harder to repair that. I know things like Shugu are pretty good at that, but if you don't have these specialty, you know, these more specialty, you know, tools to fix specialty problems, it can be a large problem. And so, you know, you may have to also carry these kinds of specialty things like Shugu to handle in the event of any of these problems. But this is a disadvantage to me, just for the fact that, once again, it's not very field repairable. I mean, you can do field repairs, but they're never going to be as good as it was in its stock condition. So that is a big thing. You do have to be a little bit more careful with bra shelters so that you don't damage them. This means that you have to be more mindful of your fires and what type of wood you're burning, because burning things like spruce, they have a lot of sap in them, and so that sap can launch hot embers at your shelters and burn little holes in them. So that's a big thing you have to watch with it, is the overall damage that you can do to these types of shelters. And once again, they're not as easily field repairable as a built shelter. So anyways, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed this little pro-con discussion about built shelters versus bra shelters. And hopefully you guys have liked some of the pictures I've rolled in. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this discussion about the pros and cons of built versus bra shelters. At the end of the day, I still am going to be using more brought shelters, especially over this year, because I just haven't really done that many. And this is the big reason why I'm starting to migrate over to brought shelters, is I just really haven't used them over the years. And so I want to begin to use them, learn how they work, and kind of play with them, and so that I can hopefully pass the knowledge on to you guys. That's one of the big things I want to begin to do with the channel, and that's the big reason why I'm actually switching over to brought shelters as opposed to just building more shelters. But anyways, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed this pro and con discussion about these shelters and their different ups and downs. Hopefully this also helps you guys decide whether you want to build your shelters or bring your shelters. There are a lot of different ways to go, but hopefully this helps. Anyways, guys, that's it for now. I'm out.